In this example, we are given that the figure shows a wire AB of mass m placed on a rough inclined plane of inclination alpha. It carries a current I, and we are going to find the minimum magnitude of magnetic induction required to slide the wire up the inclined plane. And here we can see the magnetic induction is applied in the direction normal to the plane of this incline. Now in this situation, if we draw the free body diagram of the wire by looking at its cross section, if this is the inclined plane with inclination alpha, and in the side view cross section, say if this is a wire which carries a current I, and if a magnetic induction is applied normally to this inclined plane, by right hand palm rule we can see that the wire will experience a magnetic force BIL in the direction up the incline, and it is experiencing its weight MG in downward direction. So in this situation, in downward direction, one is the component of gravity which it will experience, that will be MG sine alpha. And due to the friction on the inclined plane, as it is given that it is a rough inclined plane, if we consider mu is the friction coefficient, here we can write in downward direction it will experience the friction as mu n, which can be given by, if n is the normal reaction, it can be given by the normal component of gravity, that is mg cos alpha. So in this situation, for a wire to slide up the incline, here we can write this BIL must be more than or equal to the downward force on the wire, which are one component of gravity mg sine alpha, plus the friction force, limiting friction to start sliding, that is mu n, and normal reaction here will be equals to mg cos alpha. So we write it mu mg cos alpha. So in this situation, the value of a magnetic induction should be more than or equals to mg sin alpha plus mu cos alpha divided by IL. That will be the answer to question, as this is the minimum magnitude of magnetic induction which we require to slide the wire up the inclined plane.